Hey guys, so right now I'm gonna begin by putting my hair in sections because I just came back from the pool and my hair is really dry. So I need to condition it first instead of going straight in and shampooing my hair. I am going to use Deva Curl 1 Decadence Condition to put in my hair along with just adding some water inside so I can condition my hair. Then I'm going to twist my hair up in a bun just so it can be out of my face and so it can retain the conditioner and just keep it together until I'm ready to take it down and wash it out. I'm going to repeat the same step 2 more times, just adding water and the conditioner and just making 2 more buns on either side of my hair. Well, not hair, but head. After I finish repeating this process about 2 more times, I'm going to leave my hair to sit for about 10 minutes and then I'm going to go wash it. So here I have already taken down the buns and I accidentally dropped my detangling brush and it broke in half. So I'm going to just be using a half. So I wet my hair and I put some of the 1 Decadence shampoo in my hair to just wash out any excess conditioner that's been in my hair or maybe any flakes from the gel that I've been using or just any other buildup that's been in my hair. Now that I've washed out the shampoo and the conditioner that was in my hair before, I'm gonna go back in with the 1 Decadence conditioner. I'm gonna put like 100 layers in my hair for me to finally be able to detangle it. I'm also gonna section my hair in 2 to detangle it. It depends on how knotty your hair is. If it's really bad, you haven't washed your hair in like a week or 2, you should section it in like a bit more pieces or sections, I guess, so that you could be able to detangle it without pulling on your hair. Yeah. Now I'm going to take my detangling brush and start detangling my hair from the bottom going up. I hold my hair so that I don't pull my hair, because if I just leave my hair for the brush to pull, it'll yank it and I can feel it in my scalp and it really hurts me. And I feel this way is much better for my curls. And much better for me. There's no pain and there's less breakage when I do it like this. So I'm just gonna continue to work my hair up until I feel that my hair doesn't have anything left to detangle. So right here, my hair on this side feels pretty smooth and I don't have to jam my brush down or yank it down to try to take out anything. And I'm just using my hand as I work down to help detangle as well. Sometimes I don't even use a detangling brush or a comb. I just go in with my hand and I pull apart my hair. That method works as well if you guys would like to try it. I do see a difference between both sides of my hair. The one that was detangling and the one that wasn't. I'm just going to go back in after this and detangle the other side of my hair. So that they're both even and... Then I'm going to take the 2 parts and in the middle so that there is no knots in the middle of my hair, because knowing curly hair, they just find each other and they will do it, reinvent some kind of knot out of nowhere. So for the 100th time, I'm going to go back in with my 1 Decadence Conditioner by Deva Curl, and I'm just going to use a little bit and spread throughout my hair so that I leave a little conditioner in my hair. Because my hair already starts to get dry and it will dry out anything inside of it. And then that would make frizz appear and it wouldn't be as detangled. Now I air dried my hair. That's all I did. I did not use a t-shirt to dry my hair. I just let it dry for a few minutes while I got dressed because my hair dries so quickly. Now what I'm doing is sectioning my hair so that I can put my Deva Curl Coconut Styler in my hair and just spread it through. I'm not using as much product as I would. I would usually press it about 2 to 3 times, but my bottle is almost finished, so I can't afford to do that right now. But yeah, I'm just gonna evenly distribute it, and then I'm gonna go in with the Archangel gel, which is pretty good. Like, it just makes your curls much more defined. Like it don't harden your hair like Eco Styler would. Like, you're not gonna feel that crunch. It's just still gonna feel like soft curls, but it just defines it a lot more. So I'm just gonna keep doing it over and over to little sections of my hair, adding one pump of the coconut styler, and then evenly distributing it, and then putting some of the gel until I finish that whole side. So I feel like there definitely is a difference between this side and the other side. My curls have a different shape. I don't know if it's a different shape where they're just tighter, like the shrinkage is more real now after I've completely put the product in my hair. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but it definitely has defined my curls much more, so I feel like it is a good thing. So after this, I'm gonna go back in and do the same exact thing that I did to the other side to make it look the same. So right now, I'm gonna use my diffuser to diffuse my curls, obviously. But I'm just using, I think it's a Revlon diffuser from Walmart, nothing fancy. It was cheap, probably $20. I'm trying my best not to fluff my hair, because one time I really did fluff my hair and it was just a disaster, because the more I moved my hair, the more frizz happened. But before I diffused my hair, I did leave the product to sit in my hair for about 10 to 15 minutes, because the more I touch my hair with the diffuser, the more the diffuser blows on my hair, the product would just frizz out. Like, you really wouldn't see as much definition as you should. So as I continue to diffuse either side, I'm gonna go ahead and break my neck and flip my hair right there so I can get the shape, the definition of the shape of my hair, because I have it cut like in different layers. So definitely flipping my hair makes it stand out much more than if I had just diffused from the bottom only. I try not to leave my hair down there for too long, because if I diffuse my hair upside down too long, then my hair is gonna come out messed up. I don't know how, but it does. It just looks terrible if I keep it down for too long. So I flip my hair back over and I use my hands to just pick down my curls so that it didn't stay in the exact shape that it was when it was upside down. So I'm just using my diffuser to help fluff out my hair a little bit more. And keep in mind that at the end of this, I have diffused my hair for only a total of 10 minutes. So some sides are still gonna be a little bit flat. My hair is about 50% dry. It's only dry on the ends, but if you feel on the inside, it's still damp. Like, you can see at the top, it's still flat, and on the left side, it's flat as well at the top. So you don't have to do this part, but I don't like to see like the edges of my hair really curled up. Like, I like to see it flat. It just gives me peace. I feel like it looks prettier that way. So I just go ahead and put some Eco Styler in the front of my hair and try to continue pulling down my curls to make a better shape. And then I just brush that Eco Styler in only in the front of my hair. I don't brush any other part of my hair, just the little part that I put the gel. I'm just gonna diffuse one more time because my hair is really not as dry as I hoped it would be, but I had to leave, so I'm just, trying to get it to stay, because if I go with my hair too wet, it's just not gonna look right. Like, it's so easy to mess up my hair. I don't know why, but it's just so easy. Hey guys, so this is the final product of my hair. It'll definitely get bigger after this. In the next 7 days, I'll be like, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.